You're welcome. In this video, let us understand how to make real estate agency project. So this video will demonstrate you on Visual Basic with backend SQL Server. So let us understand what are the requisites for the real estate agent. So here the concept is real estate agent company. So this company basically collect the property information from the customers. So first we should have a customer. So therefore we collect the customer detail. Let me change the color. Right, so customer details, and we need to collect all the customer details. So next step is the property details. What are the properties customers having? So we need to collect the property details. Then here we'll give one more advantage in this project is, so we collect the pictures also, property pictures. So therefore next time for other people we can show them pictures, then easy for them to select the property. So property registration, because they're listing the property with us, so we collect the payment for them for the registration. Then we'll show these properties with the required customers. So therefore search is required. So based on search, we collect the what are the data is available, and then we list it out based on the area, based on the property type, and we'll show to the customers. If the customer is agree, they'll do the agreement with that. So for that we'll get the commission. So this company will get the commission. So therefore there is a commission form. So based on this we require a report. So in a report you have to show customer list, property list, and the commission list. So all this is required in this particular project. This is what we're going to demonstrate in this particular project. So this project will show you in VB.NET, but it's not necessary that you need to write in VB.NET. Still you can write it in that is C#. Then you can write it in Java, or you can do it in Android. Even you can write it in Python. So options are very much open. So which language you are interested, you select the language. So once you know the design, so you can implement this in any of the other languages too. Now there is a question, why it is difficult to make the project? So probably you all know, like when you need to do a project, you have a problem. So each one will have different problems. But what is the main problem? So main problem is, like, you should know the language very well. Right? So language is very important. What you know may not be sufficient to write the complete project. And you know, like, how to create the database, database design, and all these things. If you're not very sure, like, how to design database, then a lot of confusion occurs. Then again, the problem. Then the errors. So when you're working, a lot of errors will occur. Then you should know, like, how to solve the error. So error solving will come with the experience. Therefore, each day you get one error, then you have to solve it. Next day you get another error. So therefore, as the days goes, you'll be experienced. Therefore, in the beginning stretch, it's very difficult. But as the days goes, you can able to solve. So therefore, you need to start earliest and then start do the project. Probably within a short time, you could able to complete it. So now here is an example here, like, no, weightlifting. So if you take the weightlifting, a professional can lift the weight easily to win the prize. But if you ask the same thing for the kid to lift, so how kid can lift so much of weight? So same thing will happen in case of the programming also. So unless otherwise we don't know the complete programming, it may be a little difficult to write the complete project. Fine. Other apart from this, maybe there are other reasons you can figure it out. But what we suggest, how do we overcome this? So in order to overcome this, you need to start earliest. So decide the project, which project you want to do. Design the project. Right, so these kind of videos will definitely help you to design the project. Once the design is ready, then you start programming. So if you have difficulties, watch some other videos and then some other help. So then you have to write the complete project. Once that is over, then you have to make the documentations. So that what earliest is the better. In our channel, we have many videos. So please watch all the videos and learn and then implement the project. Project forms, I'll show you in the project when I demonstrate the project. And database, here we are using the Microsoft SQL Server as a backend. Now I'll show the project demo for you. So before getting into the demo, if you're not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to So you search for iBlix tutorials in YouTube, you get a iBlix tutorials channel, and that you can go to videos, you click videos, so you can browse here. So we have a lot of videos here and many project videos, so therefore watch them and please subscribe here. So if you are in a team, then you can discuss with your friends, like, and also you can share our videos with your friends. Therefore we can help many people to complete their project easily. Fine, so let's come back to this Visual Studio. So here we have Visual Studio. So this is a 2019 edition. It's a community edition. So here we already have a database here, and here are the forms. I'll show the database design. So one is the area name. So if I go to definitions, you can see that their area name and details, both are varchar. Then commission table. So here is the commission table. It's around 8 fields. The next is the customer detail. Right. Next one is picture tab. Then this is the property type. Next one is registration fee. Next one is the registration. Next one is the users tab. Okay, so you want to write down, pause the video and then write down all the table names. So let's come back to the forms. So here you can see that this is a welcome screen or flash screen. Then you have login form. Then you have MDA form. Right. Then you have module. Then area names. So in case of area name, you can see that there are two fields. You can, you should match with the table columns. So this data will go to area name. This detail go to details. And if you go to coding section, here you can see the complete code. This is to save. When you click the save, when you click save, so it will go to save record procedure. So here is the procedure. This is to check whether you enter the text box 1 or not. This is to check whether this data is already present in the table or not. If not, then we'll go to insert the data. This is to display the data in a data grid. This is to bring back the data to the text boxes. When you click on the grid, we'll bring the data to the text box. This is to modify the record. This is to delete the record. Fine. So let us run the project. So here is a welcome screen. Then we have a login form. So let me log in here. So here is the MDA form. So here is the master entries, area names. So we already entered two areas. So we used to enter more, click new, and you have to enter, and then you have to save. So when in demonstration, at least you have sufficient data. So then only it look like real time. Otherwise, if you have one or two, not go good. So enter more data and then demonstrate. Right. Next one is the property type. So we're talking about your examination, because this whole concept is basically for the academic viewpoint. And if you're doing any CS course and you need to do a project, so that way this video is definitely helpful for you. And in when you give a presentation, so we're suggesting add more data, so therefore it'll give you more mileage. So next one is the customer detail. So we have two customers. Next is the registration form. So here customer will come and they want to register their property. So we'll collect all the information of the customer and we can enter it here, and then you can save the data. There's the registration. Next is the tool utility. So here, what are the property customer having? So we can collect the pictures from them. So you can see here. So this is the layout. And if I go to browse, I have limited. Okay, I'll take this picture only. Then I can give this a house picture. So you need to collect more pictures. And then you click add picture. So this is added to this particular property. When you click on this picture, the picture will be shown over here. So this way you can show to the customers what are the property pictures available, that we can show to them. This is a desktop application where customer has come to company office. There they can view this. Right. Next is the registration fee. So once they register property with us, we collect the registration fee. So this is to collect the registration fee. Now you can see there is a small error here. So the error is due to app name. So actually in database, and the table is a prop name, so therefore you need to change to property name, PROP. Okay, so press F11 to continue. Fine. So now it's okay. So then we can continue. So we can collect the money from them. So next is a search. So when customer come looking for some particular house, so we can search this property. So it'll have a property details over here. So we can able to view all these details because we can't remember everything. Like, so this agency cannot remember all the houses which are available. And if agency is very bigger, then a lot of employees are there. All employees cannot remember everything. So therefore, when the customer comes, they can search it here. When the result comes, they can easily explain to the customer. So here is a commission. So if the property deal is okay, then they need to pay the commission here. So again, this is the property name, PROP. Right. So we can collect the commission from the property owners. So how much percentage of commission you collected, that we can write and we can save the information here. So next is the reports. Based on that, you have a customer list. Then we have a fee collection report. Then we have a commission report. So three reports are there in the project. So hope you understand the concept. Now you can able to write this project. So if you have any difficulty, please write it in the comment box. Let me know what is the problem. And we try to make another video there. We try to explain the issues and then give some solutions. So please subscribe to our channel. Don't forget. And subscribe to our channel. We can bring you more videos, more quality videos that definitely will help you to learn things faster. Thank you.